What up, kids? Gucci, get the news going. I don't have a segment this week, so you kids are going to have to step it up. Oh, wait, you always do that. You always do that. See ya.
Goodbye, sir. Thank you.
Welcome
to
MMS
News. Now,
roll
the
intro.
Amazing things.
Hello.
Good, welcome MMS, and go!
And good welcome to you too, Allison, and welcome to another great episode of MMS News Social Quarantine Distance Special Edition. We continue with Unmask Your Character here at MMS and your home. We are still focusing on the character here at our MMS community. So this week, we are looking for the children that has the most positivity. Positivity means the practice of being positive or optimistic with your attitude and views. If you show the most positivity, you might see your name scroll across the screen here at MMS News. We can't wait to see what kind of positive students we have here at MMS and streaming in from your home. The spotlight is ready to shine all the light on another superstar here at MMS. So let's turn it all on and see who gets the light on them this week.
Hi, we are Haley and Riley. Today we are talking to Miss Kay about the Spirit Club. What is Spirit Club? What is the purpose of it?
Spirit Club is an opportunity for students to get together and bring some spirit to the building. I think the more you buy into school and the relationships you build actually make you a better student overall. So it's a good way to get involved for kids that maybe aren't athletic or aren't interested in sports. It's just a good opportunity to get out and support your school.
How can kids join the Spirit Club?
Spirit Club is open to anybody 6th grade through 8th grade. It's after school on Tuesdays and Thursdays. And you can join by contacting me at my email address. Which is a really long address, so I'm going to assume they're going to post it somehow. And you can just show up at a meeting. Ask your friends who go too. They can tell you how to join.
Why do we need school spirit?
You know, the more opportunities in life you have to build connections to other people, the better and more richer your life is. And so I think school spirit is one of those ways that everybody can get behind school and be excited to be here.
What advice do you have for COVID times?
You know, we've talked a lot about grit in the last week or so. I mean, we've talked about it for the last several years, but I think resilience, if I had to pick one word that sums up how to get through COVID, is to be resilient, to know that nothing is the same. But that's okay, we can figure out a new way. And in some cases, we've made life better. We've learned how to accommodate all students in a different format. And I would say be resilient.
Thank you, Ms. K. This has been the MMS Spotlight. Remember to turn off the light.
Once again, we go to our special report crew with an update with our pretty big changes here at MMS taking place after spring break.
Hey, MMS. Welcome back to another great episode of MMS. As you might already know, we are going back to everyone coming in school 5 days a week after spring break. So you can tell, today's special report will be about talking about the new 5 days a week schedule.
The first thing that you need to know is that you will still need to wear your mask. I think we have all gotten pretty used to that. Again, make sure you are wearing appropriate masks for school.
We are basically doing the same things we did, but we will have more students in the class. Remember, April 5th and 6th will be at normal hybrids. A group will come in on Monday, April 5th, and B group will come in Tuesday, April 6th. Then the 7th, we will start coming in every day.
Lastly, even though now we only have to stay 3 feet away from each other, we still need to stay the 3 feet. I know it is exciting that we may see more of our friends, but make sure we stay 3 feet away. Remember that we should be using the hand sanitizers too. This is all for this week, MMS, and we are very excited to see more people in the office.
The calendar updater looked at every calendar ever made and has just the right day you need to start celebrating.
Hello and welcome back, MMS, to this week's calendar update. Make sure to check your calendar for this week's National Day. Today, I'll be talking about National Take a Walk Day on Tuesday, March the 30th. You can celebrate this day by, well, simply going on a walk. Take some time to go outside and enjoy nature. Take a friend or even a pet. This day is perfect because the weather is just starting to warm up. You don't have to walk. You could ride your bike, skateboard, or any other activity that gets you moving. Well, that's it for today, MMS. As always, remember, be safe, wear a mask, and social distance. But most importantly, happy National Take a Walk Day!
The Master of the Page Turn has another masterpiece that you need to be checking out before you go on spring break. So get to the library for this great review.
Hello, MMS. Welcome to the Children Book Review. This week I have Masterminds by Gordon Corman, released February 5th, 2015, the first book in a series of three. Eli has never left Serenity, New Mexico. Why would he ever want to? Then one day he bikes to the edge of the city limits and something so unexpected happens, it changes everything. Eli convinces his friends to help him investigate further, and it soon becomes clear that nothing is as it seems in Serenity. The clues mount to reveal a shocking discovery connecting their ideal crime-free community to some of the greatest masterminds ever known. The kids realize they can trust no one, least of all their own parents. What will happen to Eli and his friends? With a rating of just under 4.5 stars on Goodreads, I give it a solid 4.5. If you have any book recommendations, email them to me at tcarpent899@d15.org. Till next time, MMS, have a great spring break, keep reading, and wear a mask.
We go now to our Monster of the Week review to make sure you are the king and press play at our supersized movie.
Hello, MMS. Today I'm going to be talking about the movie Godzilla vs. Kong, coming out on March 31st. You can watch it in theaters or on HBO Max. Some people who are starring in the movie are Millie Bobby Brown, Rebecca Hall, and Chris Chalk. The movie is about some fearsome monsters, Godzilla and King Kong, who square off in an epic battle for the ages while humanity looks to wipe out both of the creatures and take back the planet once and for all. Make sure you have a monster-sized bowl of popcorn ready for this king-sized throwdown. And that's all for this week's movie review. Goodbye, MMS.
Back in the recording studio, the Top 10 has another hit single for you to listen to. Jazz hands. Welcome back, MMS, to our very own Top 10. And this week, let's just jump back into our normal Top 10 and see where your songs are this week. First and last, at number 10, we have Bang by AJ. You know this song, everybody come hang. Let's go out. Next, at our number 9, we have a requested song, Blinding Lights by The Weeknd. Next, at number 8, we have Skin by Sabrina Carpenter. You can try to get on the skin while he's on mine. Yeah, on the skin. I wish you knew that he. Next, after number 7, we have Be Kind by Hazley and Marshmallow. You know you can cry to the one, always confide in the one. You can be kind to the one that you. Next, at number 6, we have Tyro by Zion. Got me thinking about giving you something, tell me it was you. Something, tell me it was you. Down our list, at our number 5, we have Love Song by Ray Dolan. Inspiration, thinking about you. I wrote another love song, baby, about you. I've written one for every second without you. It goes like this. And at number 4, we have Line by Line by JP and Mary Moss. Never fit in it, so I just take you line by line. Next, out of number 3, we have Anyone by Justin Bieber. If it's not you, it's not anyone. Looking back on my life, you're the only good I've ever done. Almost out of number 2, we have Bright by Madison Rae. You and I, we will fight to shine together. Bright forever. Lastly, at our number one, we have Only a Matter of Time by Joshua Raskin. Tonight, no, it's only a matter of time. And I, for a night, you go blind. And when did you stop? Goodbye, Matt. Remember, keep jamming out from really 6 feet apart. And wash your hands.
Please! Want to know your favorite celebs? Favorite NCAA upset story, or if they go to Dairy Queen or Baskin Robbins, then pay attention to this week's Celebrity Fact Report.
Hello, MS. It's your girl Savannah coming back with interesting facts about the celeb Louis Capaldi, suggested by Karen. So, let's get into it. Louis's full name is Louis Mark Capaldi. He was born October 7th, 1996, so he is 24 years old. He was born in Glasgow, United Kingdom. Louis is a singer songwriter. He is known for his songs Before You Go, Someone You Love, and Hold Me While You Wait. He has at least 23 songs. He was nominated for the Critics' Choice Award at the 2019 Brit Awards. He is vegetarian. Capaldi learned to play the guitar at the age of 9. He is best pals with former One Direction band member Niall Horan. If you have celebrity suggestions, email me at shows433@d15.org. Bye, MMS. Have a great spring break.
The hottest gamer you've ever seen on a screen is ready to give your fingers blisters with this latest release.
Hey, everyone. Good morning. And today I will be reviewing a game called Witchbrook. Witchbrook has been in development for some time now. The game created by Chucklefish, the previous publisher of Stardew Valley, revealed a brand new look for the game today. Now to what the game is about. Discover spellbinding as a mystic pixel art world full of charm and intrigue in this richly detailed magical school and town life simulator. Participate in extracurricular activities such as fishing, growing magical crops, and foraging strange mushrooms. Unlike all projects made by Chucklefish, Witchbrook will initially arrive on Microsoft Windows only, although the company might launch it on other platforms like Linux, Mac OS, Nintendo Switch, PS4, and Xbox One afterward. This game is rated E. Well, that's all. Hope you enjoyed. If you have any suggestions, email me at cncguyga621@d15.org and have a great day.
After all the brackets have been busted and the tears have been dried, there are still more sports to be played. So take it away, SportsCenter.
Hi, and welcome to Sports Talk. The Illinois Fighting Illini beat the Drexel Dragons in the first round of the NCAA tournament, 78-49. As for the Ramblers, they beat Georgia Tech 71-60, so they moved on to face Illinois in the second round of the tournament. Loyola was really good offensively and defensively right from the opening tip-off. Number 8 Loyola pulled off the upset 71-58 over the number 1 Illini. Illinois' season is done, while Loyola moves on to face the Oregon State Beavers in the Sweet 16. Here are some key upsets in the first round. 15-seeded Oral Roberts over 2-seeded Ohio State, number 13 North Texas over the number 4 Purdue, 12-seeded Oregon State beating number 5 Tennessee, number 13 Ohio over number 4 Virginia, and the number 14 Abilene Christian over number 3 Texas. In the second round, number 11 Syracuse over number 3 West Virginia, number 15 Oral Roberts over number 7 Florida, number 12 Oregon State over number 4 Oklahoma State, and number 7 Oregon over number 2 Iowa. Email me at nmiller743@d15.org and tell me how your bracket is going so far. Now, let's hand it over to Justin with the NHL.
Hello, MS. Welcome back to Sports Week. Today, I'll be telling you about the NHL standings. Right now, for games, on Sunday, we have the Panthers vs. Stars. On Tuesday, we have the Canadiens vs. Senators. On Wednesday, we have the Wild vs. Sharks. On Thursday, we have the Hurricanes vs. Blackhawks. And on Friday, we have the Capitals vs. Devils. Now, for the NHL standings, it goes to the Lightnings, which are 24-6, the Hurricanes, which are 21-7, the Panthers, which are 20-8, Blackhawks, which are 15-13. But I must have a good day. Stay safe and wear a mask. Bye.
Just when you thought you could get a break, the Logo Master is back with all the madness that is this week's logo.
Hi, and welcome to Logo of the Week. Today, I'll be talking about the March Madness logo. I don't know exactly when the March Madness logo was created, but I do know it was a fairly recent logo. The logo includes the NCAA logo with the letters that say March Madness. The letters are supposed to be in a 3D shape on the bottom of the letters. Finally, it includes a part of a bracket in blue on both sides of the logo. March Madness is only used for the NCAA tournament every year in March. That is all for today, and if you have any suggestions for the next episode or questions about this logo, please email me at nmiller743@d15.org. And just remember to watch the madness that takes place in March. But don't actually get mad. Bye, MMS.
Our most treading story has ready to roll over you with another great tank.
MMS, Edgar here, back again for another episode of Tank Talks. Today we are doing the Leopard 2, a German main battle tank that is still in service today and fought in the Syrian Civil War and is currently fighting in the war in Afghanistan. It was designed by the Cross Maffei in 1970 and began its production 9 years later in 1979. The cost of making a Leopard 2, specifically the 2A6, is $5.74 million as of 2007. So that's about $7.27 million in 2021. And 3,600 Leopard 2s have been produced so far. The Leopard 2 has a mass of 6.23 tons, a length of 9.97 meters, a width of 3.75 meters, and a height of 3 meters. Plus, it has a crew of 4. That's all for now, MMS. Email me at esanchez115@d15.org for more tank ideas. And remember to say about a mouse plot. Bye, MMS!
Want a story that is warm and fuzzy? Well, we have just the one. But make sure you watch your fingers. It might just bite. Take it away, Animal Jam.
Hey, MMS!
It's your girls, Abby.
And Rebecca.
Today, we're doing top three dogs.
Number three is the Golden Retriever. Their life expectancy is 10 to 12 years, and their weight is estimated to be 65 to 75 pounds for males.
Number two is the Burmese Mountain Dog. Their lifespan is 6 to 8 years for males. Number one is the Maltese dog. Their lifespan is 12 to 15 years. If you have any other ideas, email us at aptera651@d15.org.
Or me at rhaux61@d15.org. Bye, MMS! See y'all next week! And remember, when in doubt, meow it out!
And peace signs!
Our food critics are demanding you send in all your favorite places to eat so they can try all the new food this spring. Until then, they are just going to wait and order at this week's restaurant.
Hi, MMS! Welcome back to Food Critics.
We have a sweet story for you today.
Really? A sweet story?
Anyways, today's restaurant is the Cheesecake Factory.
It has a 4.3 star review out of 5 stars.
Cheesecake Factory is located at 53 Woodfield Road, F301, Schaumburg, Illinois.
Its website is thecheesecakefactory.com.
Right now, it offers dine-in and curbside pickup and delivery.
The Cheesecake Factory is open from 11 a.m. to 10 p.m.
You can probably tell by the name, but it mainly serves cheesecake.
I know it's going to sound surprising to you since I don't like cheese, but I love cheesecake. Mm-hmm. Anyways, that's all for today, MMS.
Remember to email us suggestions, because God forbid nobody wants to give us suggestions, at mcalibri920@d15.org.
And anema43@d15.org. Also, remember to wear a mask, but not while you're eating.
The MMS Kitchen went to the store and got all the ingredients for this week's delicious treat. So let's set the timer and see what she's cooking.
Hi, MMS. Welcome to my kitchen. I'm Sam, and today I'm going to be showing you how to make peanut butter bars. So let's get started. First, line a 9x13 pan with parchment paper or foil. In a large bowl, mix together 1 cup of butter slightly cooled and 1 cup of peanut butter. Add Add in 2 cups of powdered sugar and continue mixing. Add 2 cups of graham cracker crumbs a little bit at a time until fully combined. Scoop the mixture into your pan and press it down so it's one even layer. Now set your pan aside so we can make the topping. Add a 12-ounce package of chocolate chips and 1/4 cup peanut butter into a microwave-safe bowl. Microwave at 50% power, starting with 1 minute and then going on to 30-second intervals, stirring in between each one until shiny and smooth. Pour over the peanut butter and spread into an even layer on top. That looks nice. Cover and refrigerate for 1.5 hours or until the chocolate has set. After they're taken out of the fridge, you can cut them into bars and enjoy. I hope you enjoy this delicious food, and remember, if I do the cooking, you do the dishes. See you next time when the kitchen is clean.
Having got enough random, then pay attention to this week's random facts that will surely make your eyes spin.
Hello everyone, and welcome back to another great episode of Did You Know?
Now let's welcome our special guest, Candy.
Hello everyone, my name is Candy, and I know anything and everything about cupcakes.
Well then, Candy, what can you tell us about cupcakes?
Well, did you know that cupcakes were not always called cupcakes?
Really?
Yep, they were actually called number cakes, or 1, 2, 3, 4 cakes. They were called that because it was an easy way to remember the ingredients. 1 cup of butter, 2 cups of sugar, 3 cups of flour, 4 eggs, 1 cup of milk, and 1 spoonful of soda.
Wow, that's crazy. But what else can you tell us?
Well, at first, cupcakes didn't have frosting.
What? But that's the best part!
I agree, but they used to just flavor them with spices or dried fruit.
Cupcakes were very different back then, but we have time for one more fun fact. So what else can you tell us?
Well then, did you know that the record for eating cupcakes is 29 cupcakes in only 30 seconds?
Wow, I can barely eat 1 cupcake in 30 seconds!
Well, Candy, that is all the time we have today. Thanks for coming.
Goodbye, MMS!
The Science Minute has another great experiment that you can try at home. So lock up the dog and open the windows, because this one is going to be loud.
Hi, MMS, and welcome to this week's Scientific Minute. This week, I'll be making a balloon catapult. You will need a toilet paper roll or a paper towel roll cut in half, some confetti, tape, scissors, and a balloon. First, take your balloon and cut it about halfway down like this, and then tie the bottom. Then, you're going to take your paper towel roll and you're going to stretch it around like this and make sure the toilet paper roll doesn't cave in or anything. Next, you're going to take your tape, take out a nice long piece, and then tape your long piece to the paper towel to make sure the balloon is nice and stuck on there. Then you're going to fill it up a little bit. And what happens here is when you pull back the string and let go and launch it, it causes the confetti to come out. This is a fun way to surprise your friends and family. If you have any suggestions, email me at aweinrei531@d15.org. And remember to trust in science.
The always painful looking but never long enough JFL is dropping in with the best of the worst and fails.
Hello, MMS. Welcome back to another great week of MMS News. My name is Steve, and I will show you some fails. This week, spring just started and spring break is here. And it has been getting warmer, but that doesn't mean the fails will stop coming, as I will be showing you some of the funniest fails. Now, enough with the talking and more with the laughing, let's get into some fails. First up, we have Slippery Slip.
Ha 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 ha!
never said being a penguin was going to be easy. Next up is never trust a stream.
Turn out there? So that's why I'm not really letting go right now. Still, this is...
Oh!
Everyone needs to get a little wet. At fail number 3, we have a beautiful day on the beach. It's not that beautiful when you have sand wind. And finally, at number 4, we have science at work. Until it doesn't.
Hi, miss. I'm going to be trying to prank my brother with my balloon confetti launcher thingy. Let me call him in here.
Bubba, come here! I'm going to show you Minecraft, the biggest thing I built.
Okay, what do you need to play?
Surprise!
That is all for today, MMS. Make sure to email me at sherrera606@d15.org for funny video suggestions. I'm always open to suggestions. Bye, MMS, and keep on left.
We can mess around. Stay classy, really. 6 feet away. Wash your hands, please. It couldn't be.
Okay.
5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
Can they see me?
No, Layla.
The Loyola Ramblers are heading into March Madness with a
And when you give us suggestions, don't give us ones.
She didn't mean to say that. She meant to say ones.
Yeah.
Hi, we are Haley and Riley. Today we are talking to Mrs. Kirsch about the accuracy club. Archery.
I'm gonna go. Okay. The YouTuber has turned.
I'm gonna do weird things with my face. Like, I get nervous.
That's okay, wait. You moved.
Hello and welcome back to this week's calendar update. Make sure to...
Hi, MMS. Dad, your phone's just so shocked.
That was right on the money. Oh.
Chan, what
is that? I don't know.
How do you have it in your store if you don't know what it is?
I just like put it in.
Wow, this sure is a lot of pizza. What? What else can you tell us about?
Okay, we have to do that one again. So, ready?
Hi, I'm a mess. What the?
What are you doing?
Together with anything they can find.
Can I see me?
No!
And anywhere, including the walls. Then.
Mrs. Baird, as a former Miss Woodstock, have you ever been watching an Emmy Award-winning reality show and thought, hey,
get him in a spot?
Nope, hold on, stop. All right.
5-2.
I don't know what,
I don't know what he's chewing on.
Oh wait, 5-4-3-2-1. Oh shoot, sorry.
Mr. Reardon is our favorite, isn't he?
Yes. Mr. Reardon's like the best teacher in the whole school.
He's funny. And I wouldn't say he's a great teacher, but...
Wow, Addie's up!
Your most requested story has turned up the volume to 10 this week, so get ready to blow... So...
You may see me.
No, Layla.
No, so you look like a goddess all the time. Like, what's the problem with that?
I'm ready!
Okay, you're ready. You ready?
Yes.
We're ready, okay.
Did you know that there are approximately six... Read that one. Did you know that there are approximately... Oh my god.
Thank you, Mrs. Krish.
Yeah.
This is the greatest MMS news ever. Okay.